So the two top smartphones that I would consider to be the best ones of this year would have to be the Google Pixel 4 and the iPhone 11 Pro. And if you are trying to pick the latest flagship of the year, you might be torn between the two of these, considering that these are the most similar of the bunch. You have the very similar footprints that the Note 10 doesn't have, and you've also got very fast facial recognition, great builds for both of them, and just overall, very similar features in terms of what they both are. With that said, out of the two of these, which one is the best one? That is what I'm hoping to figure out today, as I will pit both the Google Pixel 4 and the iPhone 11 Pro against each other. So, let's begin. This video is sponsored by Feefine, the makers of one of my favorite microphone kits of all time. Sound like a pro on a budget with their T669 kit. And say goodbye to overspending on audio setups moving forward. Affiliate links in the description. One of the first comparisons I would like to make is just in between the build qualities of both of these. And I do have to say that while both of these are built very well, there is a clear winner for me. So let's start off with the Pixel 4. The Pixel 4 is built from the back out of glass, obviously the same manner around the front. The back, however, is a glossy glass texture that attracts fingerprints. The trimmings around the corner are going to be aluminum instead of stainless steel this time around, so they are of a matte texture. And I have to say that even though I do consider this phone to be very attractive in its design, I don't like how the matte of the aluminum contrasts with the glossiness of the back panel for the Pixel 4. Even though I do prefer the pitch black color that the Pixel 4 offers that the iPhone 11 Pro doesn't have. And even though there's just a very tiny bezel at the very bottom, at the top there is a relatively large forehead, but I would prefer this over a notch any day of the week. So there is a bit of a conflict there. But when it comes to the iPhone 11 Pro, I have to say that I much prefer the build on this guy. So you've got a matte finish around the back with a very nice midnight green, which is what they're calling it. The lenses do look more elegantly implemented onto the rear of this phone. Also, I very much appreciate that the trimmings are stainless steel, which means that even though they're very shiny, they avoid fingerprints very easily and they still look great. Now, I've never liked the notch, I never will, unfortunately, and I have to say that this time around, the fact that the iPhone still has one isn't my favorite thing, and it does detract some points from the front, but on the back, the phone does look pretty good, and the trimmings make this phone feel more premium than the Pixel 4 for sure. So, in terms of overall physicality, the iPhone 11 Pro does get the win in terms of the exterior design and overall build. Now, for round two, we're just going to test out the speeds of both the facial recognition software on the Pixel 4 and the one on the iPhone 11 Pro. So it should be said that the iPhone 11 is going to be outright more secure than the one on the Pixel 4. Because on the Pixel 4, Google decided to purposefully, supposedly, allow the Pixel 4 to be able to be unlocked when it's looking directly into your face while your eyes are closed, which is a very huge security flaw. Now, when it comes to the iPhone 11, you do have the option to make it so that you do have to be paying attention in order for the phone to be unlocked. So your eyes have to be open and you do have to be looking at this device in order for it to unlock. So in terms of security, the iPhone 11 Pro wins. However, in terms of efficiency and speed, the Pixel 4 defeats the iPhone 11 very easily. And here's what I mean. For the Pixel 4, as soon as I even glance at my device, it will unlock instantly. It will take me straight to the lock screen, or the menu screen, I should say, without me having to swipe up in any shape or form. I just look at it and it's open. The iPhone 11 Pro, I have to wake it, I have to look at it, and then once it unlocks it, I have to swipe up in order for it to reveal the main menu. While in terms of security, it's better, in terms of practicality, it's not that great. So overall, I don't necessarily need it to be super secure, since no one that I know is going to try to steal my info or my phone. So with that said, I do much appreciate the convenience and speed of the Google Pixel 4. So I do have to give the win to the Pixel 4 in this category. Now the following test is going to be followed by the display contest. And this is a bit more of a dilemma, I would say. So the Google Pixel 4, the smaller version, which is what we're comparing it to, the iPhone 11 Pro, just the normal one, not the Max, the Pixel 4 has a lower resolution 1080p plus panel that runs at 90 hertz.
Now, the 90 hertz part is the part that matters the most to us here. So in terms of resolution, the iPhone 11 Pro does have a much higher resolution display. I have to say that while looking at both of these, it's not really all that noticeable, and I will explain why. So for the Pixel 4, you still have a very bright display that looks fantastic. Pictures and videos look incredibly sharp on here, and the colors are just right for my taste. On the iPhone 11, well, things do look very sharp and very great, and navigating through it is still very smooth with the movements of the icons and whatnot. Videos, pictures, everything still looks as it should. No complaints there. However, the colors on the iPhone, at least when it comes to some things, do seem just maybe a little bit more washed out than the ones on the Pixel 4, so I do prefer this display for that. Even though sometimes the difference in resolution can be apparent when you watch certain types of content. However, for the Pixel 4, having a 90 hertz display does make things so much better when it comes to navigating, playing games, and doing just about anything. Things just feel much smoother, and I guess you could say it's around 50% smoother since it is 90 hertz instead of 60, but navigating through the Pixel 4 does feel much nicer than it does on the iPhone. So in that case, in terms of the display, some of you might not like this, but I do give the edge to the Pixel 4 considering what it offers. So for the next round, we're going to be testing out the speakers for both the Pixel 4 and the iPhone 11 Pro. Here is a demonstration.
$300, $200, even just $100 to get a decent audio setup for startup of the sorts. If you're starting off your YouTube channel now, then you can definitely get away with going budget, and here's what I mean. Hundreds of different options to look at when it comes to that, though I'm here to tell you that most people don't have to spend $300, $200, even just $100 to get a decent audio setup for startup of a sort.
So as you were able to hear there, both the iPhone 11 Pro and the Pixel 4 actually have very distinguishable sound cues or signatures when you're putting them against each other. For one, since the iPhone 11 Pro has its speakers, both of them, at the very bottom of this display, the sound that comes from it does seem a little bit more symmetrical, as if they're all coming from the same spot, which might be a preference for some other. It means that you only have to worry about blocking one spot of the phone, and you can just readjust the phone so that you're not blocking those. With the Pixel 4, because the speakers are positioned very differently and not in my favorite orientation, I should say, since speakerphone at the top is what behaves as one of the speakers, and then there is, even though you see two speaker grills around the bottom, there's really only one that behaves as the second speaker. The audio does seem to be split in a very strange manner. However, while I thought that the iPhone 11 Pro would actually win in this segment, the Pixel 4 ended up dethroning it pretty badly. Even though the speakers are positioned weirdly, they're still louder and punchier, they have better bass, and they just sound clearer than the iPhone 11 Pros. Granted, this is still a great set of speakers, don't get me wrong, but the Pixel 4s do sound noticeably better in my opinion. So now the next step is going to be to test out gaming performance. While the iPhone 11 Pro does have overall better raw performance over the Pixel 4, and it is actually fairly clear when you look at the specs that the iPhone 11 Pro is definitely more powerful, thanks to its more power efficient CPU, and also just more powerful core counts in general, and the fact that iOS is better optimized in some ways than Android is. So that might be noticeable in some games, but in something like Mortal Kombat, where Mortal Kombat can actually take advantage of a better refresh rate, the Pixel 4 still appears to be better, it appears to be smoother. But if you're looking for more of a cinematic effect while just playing at 60 frames per second with the iPhone 11 Pro, I can actually see why this might be a preference for others when it comes to games. But for myself, I do prefer to play it at higher frame rates at any time. So the fact that this phone, the Pixel 4, has a higher refresh rate does seal the deal for me. So in my opinion, the Pixel 4 also does dethrone the iPhone 11 Pro when it comes to gaming performance. Now the next round is going to be based off of camera performance. And even though the Pixel 4 has been winning up until now, I would probably give the early win to the iPhone 11 Pro, and here's why. First off, with the front-facing camera. The front-facing camera on the iPhone 11 Pro is very sharp, it's very good, colors look very nice on this display, hands down. And portrait mode on the iPhone 11 Pro is actually still very good. It's one of my favorite things about it, as a matter of fact. Not to mention that the iPhone 11 Pro's front-facing camera on its own can do 4K, which is pretty amazing. You're not going to find that on the Pixel 4, unfortunately. The front-facing camera maxes out at 1080p, which is a massive disappointment for me. Images don't look quite as sharp, even though they still look great. but colors probably don't even look as nice as they do on the iPhone 11. I do have to say that portrait mode overall on my Pixel 4 is better than the ones on the iPhone 11. Not by a huge margin, but they are still noticeably better in the sense that they do a better job at sharpening you, the subject, and then pushing back the background behind you. Though I would say that if you are looking for a more subtle effect when it comes to portrait mode, the iPhone 11 Pro does a great job at that, and I actually really do like the portrait photos from this camera. And on the Pixel 4, you still get very good portrait photos, probably arguably even better in my opinion, considering that I really do like the complete distancing of the background. But that is all up to preference and opinions. Overall though, if I had to pick a front-facing camera, it would be the iPhone 11 Pro, just because of the colors, the sharpness, the higher resolution. There's just a lot more going for iPhone 11 Pro's camera than there is for the Pixel 4's camera, which is an irony this time around. For the next round, we're going to be dealing with the rear-facing cameras. And here we got greater competition, but not really by much. So, here we go. For starters, on the Pixel 4, you've got a set of two cameras, you've got a telephoto lens and just a normal wide angle lens that you would get on any other smartphone. That said, the telephoto on this camera is actually very impressive for what it is. You can do 8x zoom and still get relatively sharp images, even if they don't retain all of the sharpness. It's still crazy how much sharpness they can retain at that distance. I would say that this camera retains even more sharpness than the iPhone 11 Pro does when you try to zoom into a photo. When you do 2x on this camera, the iPhone 11, and when you do exactly that on the Pixel 4 does a better job there. And again, when it comes to portrait photos, I still really like the ones on the Pixel 4 even more because I really like the work that they do with blurring out the background very much and then sharpening and just bringing in the subject way more. And in terms of the rear cameras, I actually do prefer the color science on the Pixel as well. Unlike the front-facing camera, this camera is still very sharp. And I would still say that you've got an amazing set of cameras here. There's no ultra wide angle lens, which the iPhone 11 Pro does have. And this camera only supports up to 4K at 30 frames per second, which is a huge letdown for a lot of people. However, if you're into videos, then this camera has a fantastic stabilizer. It's almost gimbal level to an extent, which is a huge win if you just wanted to use this phone for videos, for example. Now, the iPhone 11 Pro has even more things to offer. As a matter of fact, I would still consider it the winner here for the following reasons. One, there's an ultra-wide lens. So this would actually be great for vlogging if you wanted to use the rear-facing camera to vlog. That would actually be a great use, or if you just wanted to take ultra-wide photography. You still have the telephoto lens. Even if it doesn't zoom all that deeply, you might not even want to use a feature that will let you zoom all that deeply. I can't think of any situation, or at least not many of them, where I would want to use 8x zoom when 2x zoom is perfectly fine in my opinion. So I would still give this one the compliments that it deserves. As for the normal wide-angle lens, it's still great. Again, photos and videos with this camera look fantastic, and you can still get 4K at 60 frames per second with the iPhone 11 Pro. It's just great. Everything looks very sharp, portrait pictures look great, and what's even better is that unlike on the Pixel 4, you can just use the wide-angle lens, the normal lens, on the iPhone 11 Pro to take portrait photos, which for the Pixel 4, even though I would say that the portrait photos are generally better on the 4, end up punching in more than you would want to. It's about 1.7 times just to be able to use portrait mode. So you do have to move yourself further back if you want to capture an image from within the same plane, if you wanted to get a similar photo. So because the iPhone 11 Pro's camera is so much easier to move and it offers so much more, I have to give the edge to the iPhone 11 Pro in this segment. And for the last round, we're going to be testing out battery life for both of these. So now the Google Pixel 4 has a 2800 milliamp hour battery. The iPhone 11 Pro does have a slightly larger battery than that. However, even though the iPhone 11 Pro is running a much higher resolution display than the one on the Pixel 4, because the Pixel 4 has a smaller battery than it should have, at least in my case, it's always running at 90 hertz versus the 60 hertz on the iPhone 11 Pro, the Pixel 4 will not last me through the entire day without me getting a warning of sorts. If I start my day at around 7 a.m. in the morning or 8 a.m. in the morning, by the time that it is 6 or 7 p.m. at night, my phone is probably close to dead. The Pixel 4. However, if I'm using the iPhone 11 Pro instead, this phone is still kicking at around that time, and it'll last me even longer thanks to the vast battery life improvements that Apple has made to the iPhones this time around, since they weren't always known for being so good at lasting throughout the day. Well, the Pixel 4 used to be the king of that. I'm not sure what Google has been doing in terms of trying to optimize that, but all I know is that Apple has done a spectacular job with the iPhone 11 Pro in terms of battery life and many other things this time around. So the winner is still going to be the iPhone 11 Pro. So in conclusion, who ended up winning the best smartphone here? Was it the Google Pixel 4 or the iPhone 11 Pro? Well, there are a couple of things to consider. For myself, it's still going to be the Pixel 4 because I'm just an Android guy and I really do like the things that the Pixel 4 offers, even if it's not everything that the iPhone 11 Pro offers. There's so many things that I wish that the Pixel 4 had that the iPhone 11 Pro has, but it doesn't. And there are a couple of things I wish the 11 Pro could have that the Pixel would have. For myself personally, it's the Pixel 4, but objectively, the truth is that the winner, a true winner, is going to be the iPhone 11 Pro. You just get many more things with the iPhone 11 Pro this time around, a lot more than even I was expecting. I was very surprised to see that this phone was so great, and you can hear me rave all about it. In my full review of this phone, I did go very in-depth with it. I can leave that down in the description if you're interested. If you were looking for the ultimate phone of between the two, even though for most of the rounds they actually ended up being tied, the iPhone 11 Pro is just the objective winner here. So there it is. So if you're interested in purchasing either the Google Pixel 4, the XL, or the iPhone 11 Pro Max, the 11 Pro, which is the one I have here, or just the regular iPhone 11, then I will be making sure to leave affiliate links in the description to Amazon. If you decide to use any of our links to make a purchase, then we do get a small commission that does help us run things a little more smoothly around here. Also, we just opened up a Patreon recently, which for as little as $5 a month, you can join our exclusive server. So if that is something that interests you, we would love to chat with you down there. Links to everything in the description. Okay, so this has been Francisco from Tech Summit. Thank you for watching, and I'll be seeing you all later. Enjoy.